Now students, come to our today's last topic, that is menstrual dysfunction. It is another physiological or anatomical change in females. The basic meaning of this menstrual dysfunction is simple one, that it is a disturbance in a regular menstrual cycle of females. Because as per the previous video lecture, on what time of age that menstrual cycle is in women is being start. But here the stage in the women's or the females where there is a disturbance in their regular menstrual cycle, that is known as menstrual dysfunction. First of all, come to the meaning of this. It is disorder or irregular condition in women's menstrual cycle. Menstrual dysfunction can be defined as an abnormal bleeding during menstrual cycle. Abnormal bleeding means in some cases bleeding flow is very high and in few cases bleeding flow is low. That is in absence of intracavity. This is a total opposite of regular menstrual cycle. Now there are few things which is related to menstrual dysfunction. Most of the menstrual cycle occurs after every 22 to 35 days. Normal menstrual flow lasts for 3 to 7 days. The amount of bleeding varies. Some have less bleeding, whereas some women have heavy and prolonged bleeding. This is the meaning of menstrual dysfunction. Now come to the premenstrual syndrome, or we can say the symptoms of premenstrual. During menstrual dysfunction, most of the women complain about breast pain, back pain, constipation. Due to the excessive bleeding, the iron in the blood reduces, and due to the excessive bleeding, the chances of anemia increases in females or the women. There are treatments of this particular menstrual dysfunction. Number one is hormonal therapy. If the in the absence of intracavity bleeding or the hormonal changes, the hormone therapy is very much helpful in this menstrual dysfunctioning. More iron food to reduce or to increase, sorry, to intake the more iron food to fulfill the need of iron in the body. Anti-fibrolytics, that is important treatment for menstrual dysfunctioning. And last one is hygiene and the personal cleanliness. Clear? Now the activities during menstrual dysfunction. Number one is moderate exercise. That is up to the depends upon the female or the women. Personal cleanliness, hygiene, very important. And if the complications are arises due to the exercises or the physical activities, then the women or the female must consult to the doctor or gynecologist. Today's video class, we are go through from the three basic main topics. Number one is woman participation in India in sports, starting of physiological and anatomical changes in women's, that is menstrual cycle, and the next important physiological and anatomical change in women, that is menstrual dysfunction. So today's class is, and if you are having any doubt, please discuss those doubts on our class WhatsApp group. Thank you.